Hi everyone, we're going to learn Jan. In this video I want to tell you a little bit about renting a car in Spain. So we are renting from company rentacarspain.com. Yes, so rentacarspain.com. So I found this company on the internet. When I was searching all over it, I found that it was the best deal of everything I could find on the internet. So I was looking for an automatic car. So there are so many companies offering manual cars and they are much cheaper than renting an automatic car, but because I wasn't driving for a very long time, I wanted to have an automatic car. I do really love it. It's easy, easy to drive. And so we're renting a car for 3 months, so like from middle of July till beginning of October, so that's end up for us about 1,600 euros. So it's not bad, it includes full insurance. So if you will be renting a car in Spain, when you check online, usually the companies offer you not full insurance. So you would have some insurance, but when you usually go to the rental place, you will find out they would want you to buy an extra insurance. We had it once a long time ago, we've been through this, so that's why now we're always looking for full insurance straight away. So, and also bear in mind that full insurance would probably cost about half of price of just rental a car. That's what they usually show you. Very good deals, you think, and then you have to pay for a full car insurance, then it would end up a little bit more expensive. Thank you. So, what I was talking about, that usually you would have half price, so the insurance would cost mostly double the price. So, but it covers everything, even the scratches, so which is very good, because when you are driving in Spain, the roads are very narrow and especially the parking spaces are very narrow. If you are from America, they will be very hard for you. I know that, because in America the spaces are huge, you can put two little cars in there. Here you can hardly squeeze a very small little car. So you have bushes, you have other people not parking well in Spain, so you really need a good insurance, believe me. So, that's about renting a car, so I told you a little bit about it. Now I'll tell you a little bit about where I am, what I'm doing here. So I'm here in Malaga, and I was telling you about this, how much it cost here in Malaga area. So we bought our car right from the airport. So this company, what is good with them, it's not sponsored by the way, it's just an honest review, the experience I have. They bring the car in the airport. That was really good. One thing, and also bear in mind that many companies will not be open out of the opening time. So, like, I don't know, some companies would work up to 6 o'clock in the evening, 6 p.m. or maybe 8 p.m. would be latest, could be some of them 10 p.m. and that's it. Out of the hours, they wouldn't do anything. That's why it could be hard to find a company which will be working 24 hours. So we arrived here at around 10:30, and our car was already waiting us in the airport. So the representative met us in the airport, gave us a car, and perfect. So with the other companies we had, they will drive you to the car park place, but this company just was really very convenient. So also we like the, I like the service, because they talk to you and they help you with everything you need, so they answer you straight away. We had a bit of a problem with the car. Unfortunately, it was really late and we were too tired. And this I said to my husband, you should have checked everything. Like, I complained, like, you didn't do what I told you to do. You should have checked stuff. He's, by the way, sitting right there. And as usual, doesn't have his coffee. No, it's your coffee. And because, well, usually we didn't have any problems, I understand. But I always tell him, check everything is okay. This time we didn't. So he said, yeah, I checked. And so we drove away, but it was very light in the airport, and then we come out on the dark street, we find out that the headlights didn't work properly. We had, like, I think one bulb is working on one side, the other side was not working at all. So hardly enough we got to our place, because it was too late, the office was closed already, so we couldn't return the car. And they probably wouldn't find us a replacement anyway. That's the only downside they did. They should have really checked if the headlights working, because they were delivering the car in at night, so they would should have expected that people will be driving at night, and it's really hard to drive with one light. And I don't know, but I think in Spain also police wouldn't like it when you drive with bad headlights. So, and also there is no light inside the car, and it's like, unfortunately now place where we are staying, we have a garage and there is no light where our parking space. So it's so dark in the garage. So we called them and asked if we can replace the car or they can fix it. So they said, yes, no problem, just bring the car back. So it's a little bit long way back to Malaga from Soto Grande. It's around 1 hour, 40 minutes, 2 hours, depends on the traffic. So it wasn't too bad today, but it's very hot, like plus 44, but what, 90 Fahrenheit, so it's really hot. So we dropped off the car in the garage and now we are waiting. I don't know how long it's going to take. I think right now it's already about 1 hour. But we thought it wouldn't be too bad because so we end up now in this restaurant. I just had my gazpacho and now my husband had some fish and we're having a cup of coffee now and like a little bit of drinks. We were supposed to meet our friends. They also arrived here in Spain and, on holiday, but on the other side of Malaga. So yeah, and but they were also screwed. They rented an apartment and I don't think they had a car parking next to the apartment or something. They parked the car and this morning they come out to just drive here to meet us because we thought we drop our car, they will meet us here and then we'll just drive away somewhere and while we're waiting for our car repaired. But they had where they parked, it's a market today, right? And their car was towed away, so they didn't know where it was taken. They don't speak any Spanish. They went to Spanish police office and couldn't understand anything. So somehow they managed to figure out and they had to drive to one town, to police station. And from that town, they had to drive somewhere else, pay the fine. I think it's 100 euros fine, 200 euros fine. So and that's like, yeah, really not very nice for them. But looks like it's okay now, so maybe we will still meet up with them here. So that's maybe a little bit of adventures we have here. So and I wanted to share with you a little bit while we're sitting here waiting, nothing else to do. So I talked to you a little bit about all these interesting things happening and about renting the car in Spain too. So I think that's all, guys, for now. Also, of course, if you will be renting a car, if it's not going to be new, so I think it's Ford we rented. It's really big because we need it. They have new cars. Oh, okay. Yeah, well, yeah, that's what I was gonna say. We needed a big boot because we have a wheelchair for my mom, so we asked for a bigger car, and this they tried to get us a nice, reasonable size car. So it was really nice of them. Yeah, for the same price as a small car. So my husband mentioned that they do have a nicer and newer cars, but because we really need a specific one, a bit bigger boot, they could get whatever they could get, as I'm saying. Also, automatic cars is a very big problem here in Spain, so with manual cars there is no problem. And the smaller cars, last time I don't know if we rented with them or not, I had a smaller car and it was a new car, I think. It was small and nice to drive, but this time it's a bit big. So that's all, guys. Hope this video was a little bit interesting and maybe useful for some of you. If you really like it, don't forget to subscribe and I see you later. There will be more video vlogs from Spain. Bye everyone!